from water every living thing. Water is an essential element to life. It touches every aspect of our lives, from public health to safety to the foundation of our economy. We put water to work in a million different ways, but do we even know its true value? We are so used to turning on the faucet and having access to safe water 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, that rarely do we stop and think. What does water mean to us? Do we value this precious resource? What if we run out of water? As a response, in this video, we wanted to provide you with an overview of the issue of water scarcity, as well as a glance of which industries consume the most water. To be conscious of the water footprint left by some of our everyday products, and perhaps to begin thinking wisely and putting a higher value on water. There is plenty of water on Earth. 71% of our planet's surface is covered with water. However, the fresh water for our basic survival needs only represent 3% of the world's water. Of that, most fresh water is unavailable, as it exists in glacier, polar ice caps, atmosphere, and soil. This leaves us with 0.5% of Earth's water fresh and ready for us to use. As a result, 2/3 of people on our blue planet live in areas where access to fresh water is an issue. Water scarcity impacts every continent, and as a result, 1.1 billion people do not have access to water. Yes, as you heard, 1.1 billion people suffer from water scarcity. By 2025, it is expected that half of the world's population will live in areas facing water scarcity. This is mainly a result of climate change, growing population, and land use change. Now, you may be asking which industry consumes the highest volumes of water. So, all industries have a certain water footprint. However, let's get an overview of the ones that require the biggest amounts of fresh water. First, agriculture. 70% of the world's fresh water is used for agriculture. This is due to agriculture's water use for irrigation, fertilizer and pesticide application, crop cooling and frost control. As a result of the fertilizers and insecticides used in agriculture, it is also a major source of water pollution. When it comes to the 30th crop, wheat, corn, rice, cotton, and sugar cane take the lead. Nuts are also a source of concern, especially since 74% of irrigated nuts are grown in regions facing water stress, like India, China, Pakistan, the Mediterranean area, and the US. Here you have some products which production needs a huge amount of water. Chocolate, for example. To produce 1 kilogram of chocolate, we need approximately 17,000 liters of water. Yes, it's too much. And to produce 1 kilogram of coffee, we need around 15,000 liters of water. Now let's see the fashion industry. Fashion industry, apart from being a significant source of water pollution, the fashion industry also uses considerable amounts of fresh water. The 79 billion cubic meters of fresh water used yearly by the fashion industry secured its place as the second most water-consuming industry in the world. This is mainly because of cotton's high water demand. It takes 7,000 liters of water to produce one pair of jeans, the same amount one individual drinks in 5-6 years. A t-shirt requires 2,700 liters of water, enough for a person to keep thirst away for almost 3 years. Meat industry. Generally speaking, animal products like meat, dairy, and eggs are linked to higher environmental impacts than fruits and vegetables. This includes bigger levels of greenhouse gas emission, land use change, and water use. Meat production is a separate industry, but we have to remember it is intimately linked to agriculture. Some estimates say that 1/3 of the fresh water used for agriculture is a result of meat production. Beef is by far the most water-intensive food on our plates, followed by lamb, goat, poultry, eggs, and cheese. It should be noted that other sources include nuts as the second highest water consumer in the food industry. It takes 15,000 liters of water to produce 1 kilogram of beef and over 10,000 liters to bring 1 kilogram of sheep meat to our tables. Wow, that numbers maybe will let us rethink our diets, who knows. Let's move on to the automotive industry. Finally, here are some thought-provoking facts about how this industry consumes water. It takes around 148,000 liters of water to produce a car. Producing one tire only requires close to 2,000 liters. Major water uses in the automotive manufacturing industry includes surface treatment and coating, paint spray booths, washing, rinsing, hosing, cooling, air conditioning system, and boilers. The component manufacturing segment has its own list of water-intensive processes. In addition to the use of water for these processes, there is the matter of wastewater, which then needs to be treated to high standards in order to meet environmental regulations. There are still a lot more sectors and products that use a lot of water that we couldn't include into one video. To summarize, human health, food security, energy supply, city sustainability, and ecosystems all require water. Overuse, pollution, and climate change are all putting pressure on the world's water system today. Extreme weather, droughts, and floods are wreaking havoc on communities all around the world. Hundreds of millions of people lack access to safe drinking water and sanitation at home. A growing population and an expanding economy are driving up demand. It's time to continue or start valuing water in every manner we can, no matter how minor it is. Avoid waste and promote conservation are some simple examples we can start implementing in our daily life. Let's act before it's too late. Thank you for watching, and if you enjoyed this content, don't hesitate to like and subscribe. Thank you. See you soon. Bye-bye.